What is the difference between physical and chemical property? No doubt, both of them, they will be defining you the characteristics of the substance. So what is the difference among the two? In first case, in case of physical properties, we will be measuring the properties of the substance without changing the identity or composition of the substance. What I am telling? Physical properties are the properties which are studied without changing the identity and also the composition. For example, if I go, I can give you that is odor. Odor means aroma or smell. Okay. Then color, then boiling point, melting point. See, if you go for boiling, if you're boiling one glass of water, it will boil when the glass of water attains the temperature that is 100 degrees Celsius. Similarly, if you go for boiling one bucket of water, no doubt that one bucket of water also boils when the system attains the temperature to be 100 degrees Celsius, unless it won't boil. So that boiling point is a quantity or the property which will not involve change in the composition or identity. Similarly, odor, it is aroma or smell. If you go for smelling any substance, 1 kg or 1 gram, no doubt the smell will remain same. It won't change when I change the quantity. Same way color, same way melting point. So these are the properties which are studied without changing the identity or composition of the substance. Now coming to second kind of property, that its name is chemical property. Here, chemical property refers to, no doubt, the properties which are studied by changing the identity or composition of the substance. Ulta, it is not involving the change, but it involves change in the identity or composition of a substance. Good examples are combustibility. Combustibility. Then after acidity, then basicity, etc. So these are some of the properties which is involving change in the identity or composition of the substance. For example, combustibility. What do you mean by that combustibility? Combustibility is a property that is, here the substance is burnt in presence of oxygen. That property is called as what? That phenomenon is called as what? Combustion. That ability is combustibility. What is acidity, basicity? Acidity refers to the number of OH minus with which the acid can get combined. Similarly, basicity refers to the number of H plus ions with which a base can get combined. Here, the detailed study we will see whenever it is required, but now I don't want the things, so I just want to tell that in three properties it is measured by change in the composition. This was about the properties of matter. Moving further, we have some physical quantities and its measurements. You might have studied this in already physics. We have seven physical quantities and those are having some specific units, that is called as SI unit. What is the full form? International System of Unit. SI unit refers to International System of Unit. It means it is common worldwide. Wherever you go, when we are using quantity or when you are using the unit of the quantity in such units, such measurements, it is common everywhere. So such units are called as what? SI unit. And all the physical quantities should, no doubt, it should be represented or ended with the unit, and those should be in SI only. Now, as I said, there are seven. You will say, what are those? One is, that is, we make a column to make it understand easily. First column is quantity. Second is its symbol. Third one is the SI unit, that is, what is the unit of its measurement in terms of our system, that is international unit of system, international system of units. Then last, that is symbol of SI unit. What is the symbol of SI unit? As I said, there are seven physical quantities. The first one is length. Length, okay. Length symbol is small letter L. Its SI unit of measurement is meter. Always the length is measured in meter. No doubt it can also measure other units like centimeter, inches, all things. But I got SI, standard units. So it is meter. What is the symbol of SI unit? Small letter M. Second quantity is mass. Its symbol is small letter M. What is the SI unit? SI unit is kilogram. Kilogram. And the symbol of SI unit is kg. Kg. The third kind is time. Time. Symbol is small letter T. Its SI unit is seconds. And the symbol of SI unit is small letter S. The fourth kind is thermodynamic temperature. Thermodynamic temperature. Okay, its symbol is capital T. Its SI unit is Kelvin. Symbol K. Now, fifth one is amount of substance. Amount of substance. It is given in small letter N, and its SI unit is moles. M-O-L-E-S. In terms of moles in measure, symbol is M-O-L. Now the sixth kind is luminous intensity. Luminous intensity. It is, its symbol is IV. Okay, its SI unit is candela. And the symbol is CD. Candela CD. The seventh kind is electric current. Electric current. Its symbol is I. Okay, SI unit is ampere. And symbol of SI unit is capital letter A. So these are some physical quantities whose symbol as well as its SI unit you people are supposed to remember, because these are frequently used, and as I said, all the quantities has to end with the units, and the commonly accepted unit is in terms of what? SI, international system of units. I am repeating. Length, symbol small letter L. SI unit is meter, symbol small letter M. Mass, small letter M. It is always measured in kilograms, and symbol is kg. Time, symbol small letter T. It is measured in seconds, SI unit seconds. Symbol is S, small letter S. Coming to temperature, symbol of representation is capital T. Its SI unit is Kelvin, and the symbol will be K. Now this amount of substance, its symbol will be small letter N, and measured in terms of what? Moles. Its unit will be mol. Then after luminous intensity, these two things will be studied in, it is maximum used in physics, not in chemistry, but all but five things you will be most using in chemistry part. Okay, luminous intensity, symbol is ID. SI unit of measurement is candela.